I have many patients who are TMD sufferers who also have a history of anxiety, and they love doing this as an exercise because they can literally feel their whole body settling down.
Hi, my name's Timothy King. I'm a myotherapist.
Hi, my name's Sarah Beach, and I want to give you a really warm Aussie welcome for joining myself and the amazing Timothy King for our online program that we've designed for you together.
We want to unpack for you in this training just how simple some of these solutions can be for TMD, for headache, and also for orofacial, various autonomic orofacial dysfunction.
If we can decrease an individual's anxiety or at least help them to manage it better, we are going to have better outcomes with their chronic pain. We know that the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system somewhat stimulate two opposite effects within the body. So the sympathetic response, a highly sympathetic nervous system, that is a fight or flight response, versus a highly parasympathetic nervous system, which is really that rest and digest phase. Patients who have high anxiety, and even patients that suffer depression also, will often be in a state of high sympathetic tone. That is, they're constantly in that fight or flight type of situation, and that really contributes to perpetuating chronic pain and affecting sleep quality and many other factors relating to chronic pain. And so if we can get a patient out of that sympathetic tones, that state of sympathetic tone, out of that fight and flight type of situation, and ease them into the parasympathetic, then that's much, much better. Now, breathing plays a huge role. When an individual is anxious, they will tend to chest breathe rather than diaphragmatic breathing. This is all going somewhere. This simple exercise is incredibly effective because it is so multifactorial. We like to call it, because we kind of made it up, Sarah Beach and myself, so we call it beaching, which is a pretty appropriate name considering it's an idea or a little exercise that's been inspired by Sarah Beach and Timothy King. And so we want your patients. I even get patients that present with TMD, even if I'm not sure if there's a real complexity, if they're a chronic pain sufferer, I'll normally get them to commence this exercise even from week one anyway, because it's simply so multifactorial, so simple, and so effective. So, neutral cervical spine, flat surface, chin tucked. It's got to be a flat surface. The mattress is too soft. Make sure it's a firm surface like the carpet or a yoga mat. Tongue on spot. We want to promote that and train that tongue to sit where we know it should, on the roof of the mouth. Lips sealed, nasal breathing. For some people, this is quite difficult, and it's a real retraining process. If you need to deal with allergies or other blocked nose issues, then make sure you deal with those so that the patient can nasal breathe. Diaphragmatic breathing, one hand on the diaphragm, one hand on the chest. We, in a normal resting state, we should all diaphragmatically breathe. It is normal to chest breathe, so for the chest to heave and breathe when you are exerting yourself with exercise, perfectly normal. It's the way the body gains additional oxygen. However, in a resting state, diaphragmatic breathing should be normal, and for many people who suffer from anxiety, they need to train themselves to do it. We commence with 10 minutes, two times a day for 10 days, and then we reassess. So this is a great little protocol, super, super simple, multifactorial, and I really encourage you to give this to patients who have a long history of TMD, or if you suspect that their pain is chronic and ongoing.